I highly suggest you stop talking about my nephew.
Who's scared of you now?
I'm sorry, I don't talk.
Y'all looking stupid right now.
Survivor, the quintessential reality TV game show. As of recording this, the show is roughly midway through its 41st season, and with that much history, it should go without saying there's a lot to the show. While the casual fan can easily recognize the host and how much money is on the line, there's much more information that lies below the surface. This is the Survivor Iceberg, a 10-tier iceberg with over 200 topics to discuss. The list was formed through my own observations, as well as three other iceberg charts I found on Reddit that I will leave links to in the description below. And seeing as my computer has an awfully tiny amount of storage, this is going to be the first of two parts, covering tiers 1 through 5. The subjects we'll be focusing on include common knowledge, iconic moments slash quotes, memes slash inside jokes, international Survivor, and references slash other appearances. Before we jump into it, I wanted to say up front that I apologize for any names I pronounce incorrectly. I know in the international section I called Jenna, Gina, and Annalise, Annalise, so again, I'm sorry. Also, there's not a shadow of a doubt in my mind that there are some things missing throughout the list. While I wish I got every nook and cranny of info, I also view it as allowing y'all to discover even more shocking information on your own. With all of that out of the way, let's get into Tier 1, Common Knowledge. Jeff Probst, the host of the TV series, he would become a producer before Season 18 Token Sheens. The tribe has spoken. The phrase spoken by Jeff Probst when the voted out contestant's torch is snuffed.
Joel, tribe has spoken. That's a go.
Hatch wins the first season. Richard Hatch is the winner of the first ever Survivor season, Survivor Borneo.
Congratulations, Rich.
Scoopin falls in the fire. After inhaling smoke from the fire in Season 2 Australian Outback, Michael Scoopin would fall in, suffering major burns so extreme that he became the first medically evacuated castaway. Rob and Amber love story. We see the beginning formation of the couple of Rob Mariano and Amber Burkitch during Season 8 All-Stars. They are still together today. Tony is the GOAT. Many regard Tony Vlachos as the greatest of all time in Survivor after winning two seasons, one of them being all winners. Sandra wins twice. Sandra Diaz-Twine is a four-time Survivor player known for winning her first two outings on the island with Season 7 Pearl Islands and Season 20 Heroes vs. Villains. Russell found a lot of idols. Russell Hands was infamously known as the guy to go around finding idols without any clue, specifically starting in Season 19 Samoa.
I think I just found the second hidden immunity outer without a clue.
Making our way through the first half steadily, let's move on to Tier 2, Iconic Moments slash Quotes. Ozzy Blindside. In Episode 10 of Survivor Micronesia, Season 13 Cook Islands alum Ozzy Lust was voted out in a blindside, feeling most burned by his fellow Cook Islands alum Parvati Shallow.
I never in a million years thought that you could do that to me. You put a price on our friendship. You threw us away like garbage. You basically said, you know what, you're not quite worth this much money.
Mutiny. An offer of mutiny was presented in Episode 9 of Cook Islands, which gave contestants the chance to switch tribes. Candace and Jonathan were the only two to switch, leaving Aitutaki with four members to the new Rarotonga's 8.
1. Jonathan mutinies at the last second, that is it.
Fucking Stick. Jason from Season 16 Micronesia had found a fake idol on Exile made by Ozzy. Assuming it was real, he showed Eliza, who went off on him saying it's certainly not real.
It's not the idol.
Yes, yes.
Ozzy must have put it in there. He must have the real thing. That's not the idol.
What is it?
It's Nick.
The Dragon Slayer. What three-time Survivor player Coach refers to himself as. The term was originally born in Season 18 Token Sheens.
Or do you want to call me the Dragon Slayer because I'm cutting the head off of the dragon? You guys call me whatever you want to because at this point in time, I feel brilliant.
JT Russell. Assuming Russell had the numbers against him as he was the only male remaining in the Villains tribe in Episode 9 of Heroes vs. Villains, JT gave Russell his idol. Russell used this information against JT, sending him out in the following episode.
Out and the third member of our jury. JT, that's 3, and tonight that's enough.
Parvati double idol play. A memorable move from season 20 Heroes vs. Villains, where Parvati plays two idols for people other than herself in Jerry and Sandra, sending JT home.
Jerry, that one's for you too.
Damn it.
Snakes and Rats. Sue's infamous final tribal council speech from season 1 Borneo, directed at Kelly Wigglesworth.
This island is pretty much full of only two things. Snakes and rats. We have Richard the snake and Kelly who turned into the rat. It being the end the way Mother Nature intended it to be, for the snake to eat the rat.
James goes out with two idols. James from season 15 China is voted out of the game with still having two idols in his possession.
10th person voted out and the 4th member of our jury. James, that's 4, that's enough. Need to bring me a torch.
Yao Man Dreams Car Deal. Season 14 Fiji castaway Yao Man won the car challenge and gave it to Dreams if he promised to give Yao final immunity if he won. While Dreams would win final immunity, he held on to it for himself, sending Yao Man to the jury without a car.
I'ma keep it.
Yao Man, tribe has spoken.
Dominic and Wendell tie. There was a tie between two of the final three castaways in season 36 Ghost Island, leaving the other finalists to vote for the winner.
For the first time in 36 seasons of Survivor, we have a tie.
Tyson votes himself out. In season 20 Heroes vs. Villains, Tyson's alliance planned on splitting the votes between Russell and Parvati in case Russell had an idol. Wanting to ensure her exit, he voted for Parvati while the three remaining rogue votes were towards him. When Russell used an idol on Parvati, it was between Russell and Tyson, which would have been a tie if Tyson had voted for Russell.
Oh man, I have nobody to blame but myself. I was the victim of my own stupidity.
I can get loud too, what the fuck? Sandra's rebuttal to Johnny Fairplay in Season 7 Pearl Islands during an argument on who should sit out during a challenge in Episode 3.
What are you talking about?
Swing from the boat when we jumped off the boat and we went to the shore. If you beat me so bad and I just used my arms, how bad did you beat me?
You know what? I can get loud too. What the fuck? I can get loud too.
I don't want to argue with you. That's what I'm from you.
I want to give individual immunity to Natalie. After winning the final 5 immunity challenge of Survivor Micronesia, to show his loyalty, Eric gave away his immunity to Natalie, inadvertently sealing his fate.
I want to give individual immunity to Natalie.
I don't know about that. Sandra's confessional in reference to Russell talking about how no one would vote for her leading up to Final Tribal Council of Heroes vs. Villains.
I'm feeling wonderful because regardless, Russell's keeping me around. Because I'll never get a single vote. But I don't know about that.
Jacqueline, did you vote for who I told you to vote for? At the final 5 of season 29 San Juan del Sur, Natalie organizes a blindside of Baylor with Jacqueline. Before using her idol on Jacqueline, Natalie says this to fully secure the plan.
I was gonna play this for myself tonight. Idols are more fun when you play them for somebody else. Jacqueline, did you vote for who I told you to vote for? I'm playing this for Jack.
Okay.
Hold up, bro. Max in season 30 worlds apart to Jeff, implying that he has an idol. It is ultimately nothing, however. He just says he's always wanted to do that.
Hey, Jeff. Hold up, bro. I just always wanted to say that.
Stick to the plan. After not being part of the majority alliance in San Juan del Sur, Keith Nail said this line during Tribal Council to make it seem as if there was a plan that large alliance didn't know about, prompting them to use advantages. The plan would end up working against him, however, as his son Wes would end up being voted out.
Idols are everywhere. Idols are everywhere. I say stick to the plan.
9th person voted out and the 3rd member of our jury. Wes, you need to bring me your torch.
It's love.
I ain't finished playing just yet. Move from season 19 Samoa where, after everyone assumed Russell was the next one out, he pulls out an idol at Tribal Council, saying this line in the process.
I ain't finished playing just yet.
You take care of her, I'll take care of you. what Rob says to Lex about saving Amber after the tribe swap in Season 8 All-Stars. When it gets to the merge, the promise doesn't save him, however, as he becomes the first jury member.
If you can.
What kind of a friend are you, Rob? What kind of a friend were you to me? You asked me to do you a favor, bro to bro, friend to friend, and I did the only thing I could do. You repaid that by putting a knife in my back.
I'll take my clothes off for chocolate and peanut butter. During the Purge Immunity Challenge in Episode 7 of Season 6, The Amazon, castaways Heidi and Jenna would strip naked and essentially throw the challenge for chocolate and peanut butter.
I take my clothes off for chocolate and peanut butter.
Get the girls some chocolate and peanut butter probes.
1, 2, 3.
Oh my God.
Ta-da!
All the kids at school, I'm not looking.
Join her on the bench over there.
She died, dude. During the loved one's visit of Survivor Pearl Islands, Johnny Fairplay's friend comes out, revealing that his grandma died back home. After they win the reward of spending more time together, it is revealed that this was one big lie prepared between the two before even coming on the island.
She died, dude.
He said, outsmart and outthink. He's got to outplay everybody. And he's like, if you come down here, tell me my grandma died.
The fake dead grandmother could easily go down as the dirtiest thing ever to be done in this game.
Anytime you go to Vegas, bet on black. Sean Rector as he votes John out, making him the first jury member of Season 4 Marquesas.
Checkmate, bruh. Thought you had me. So anytime you go to Vegas, bet on black. But we definitely gonna have chicken and waffles when this whole thing is done.
Natalie. After Natalie was voted out in Season 37 David vs. Goliath, Angelina kept asking if she could have her jacket as she was leaving, which amounted to nothing.
Natalie, need to bring me your torch?
I just wanted to give you a hug. I'm sorry.
Okay.
Natalie, is there any way I could have your jacket?
Tribe has spoken.
Thank you, Jeff.
Natalie.
Continuing, we have now made it to Tier 3. Memes/inside jokes. Jimmy T is Malcolm from the future. Many fans think Season 21 Nicaragua's Jimmy T looks like an older version of three-time contestant Malcolm Freeburg. I found a lemon tree. A seemingly out of nowhere quote from Yao Man in the premiere episode of Season 14 Fiji.
Look, and there's this big beautiful cave. We're like, this is a blessing. We're like, we're great.
I found a lemon tree.
Leaf's box. Season 24 One World contestant Leif Garrett had dwarfism. As a result, he had his own box to sleep in back at camp. FFGCSDTA. People referring to Survivor alumni Sierra from Season 30 Worlds Apart. The acronym stands for Fan Favorite Game Changer Sierra Dawn Thomas Anglim. The fan favorite comes from a Price is Right showing, and she was cast in Game Changers, though not many people had viewed her as a Game Changer from her other season. Bye Bye Denver Diva. Written by Clay for a vote directed at Gandia and the Thailand Tribal Council she proceeds to be voted out in. Jeff isn't impressed.
Who wrote Bye Bye Denver Diva? Who's the name?
Gandia.
Denver Diva.
In the future, write a name down, okay? Enough with the nicknames.
You better be ready. The theme song in the teasers and trailers for Season 40 includes someone singing You Better Be Ready, which doesn't seem to fit the season or show's aesthetic.
Yo!
You better be ready.
Cochran Boat. Debbie gets sent to exile in Season 34 Game Changers, which turns out to be a boat with a feast laid out. On the boat is also Season 26 Karamoan winner John Cochran, who was meant to help Debbie strategize, but she didn't pay attention to anything he said.
Debbie, it was immediately obvious that one of her fatal flaws is overconfidence.
Redemple Temple. A rewording of Redemption Island that was popularized via a Reddit post of someone's Twitter draft that said, replace Redemption Island with Redemple Temple. Who's Mary? When Joel explains to Kathy that they will be voting out Mary in Season 16 Micronesia, she's completely oblivious to anyone named Mary on the season, as were the majority of fans watching.
When I come back from Exile Island, boy, right away, Joel steps up to me and goes, it's Mary. I'm like, where did Mary come from?
The Immunity Willard. Because none of the Karor tribe were voted out prior to Willard, a meme was made that Season 10 Palau contestant Willard was the immunity, so anyone who won him would be safe. The Maddie GIF. There is a GIF of season 17 Gabon's Corinne, Maddie, and Sugar reacting to Marcus being voted out. I saw Carter Williams at a grocery store. Originally a copypasta posted on 4chan in 2012 regarding Flying Lotus, the I saw blank at a grocery store meme exists in the Survivor community with the name of season 25 Philippines player Carter Williams. Survivor sucks. A longtime forum website centered around the discussion of solely Survivor, Robbed Goddess. Referring to previously female castaways that fans believe should have won a season but didn't, the periods between the R and G denote how they were used so frequently on the Survivor Sucks online forum that the words became censored. The periods aided them in getting around that. She voted out her mom. Jeff Probst mentions how season 27 Blood vs. Water contestant Sierra had voted out her mom, who was a show alumni, whenever he gets the opportunity to.
She voted out her mom!
Bye, Shell. Many online fans have speculated that Michelle Fitzgerald, winner of season 32 Cal Rock and season 40 Winners at War finalist, is bisexual.
Also, apparently, you know, I need to talk a little bit about gay rights and being bi Shell. I love the gays. Gay pride all the way, so this is amazing.
What was his birth name? If it wasn't Coach, it was Benjamin. The show's 23rd season of South Pacific brought two returning players in Coach and Ozzy. Because of her lack of respect for Coach, rookie castaway Stacy had begun calling him Benjamin when he always preferred being called by Coach.
Your way of fighting back is to saying, I will not honor the Coach name.
What's his name? What was his birth name? It wasn't Coach, it was Benjamin, wasn't it?
Candace from Roro Tribe? In the second tribal council of season 13, Cook Islands, Billy tells everyone around he found his true love at the challenge after thinking Candace mouthed the words, I love you, to him. Jeff asks again for clarification as he's so taken aback.
I fell in love in this game. Love at first sight. Her name is Candace. And in between,
Candace from Roro Tribe.
Yeah.
Hi, Allison. Season 37 David vs. Goliath castaway Allison Raybould says she casually browses the Survivor subreddit. As a response, many people began putting up post after post saying, Hi, Allison. The Funny 115. A former writer for Survivor Central had begun making lists of the 115 funniest moments of Survivor. The first version includes seasons 1 to 11, the second includes seasons 12 to 20, and the third includes seasons 21 to 30. See ya, money. Being a fan of Survivor, the celebrity singer Sia has given money to a handful of her favorite contestants in seasons past at the reunions. Notable ones include her $50,000 for season 32 Ty, as well as her $14,000 for season 36 Donathan, and $14,000 for season 37 Davey. Yule. During season 40 Winners at War, someone on the Survivor subreddit posted a thread saying Yule and nothing else. Following this was a bunch of Yule memes showing up on the forum, with Yule even jumping in on the fun himself. CGI Brett. Because of his invisible edit throughout season 19 Samoa, many fans describe Brett as being a CGI character added into the season in the final episodes to add some suspense. Mogo Mogo Boat. A reference to the boat the Mogo Mogo tribe comes in on in season 8 All-Stars. People merely saying the phrase was so frequent on Reddit, there was its own subreddit that opened up over a year ago. The Amanda Kimmel. A running gag that started because of season 15 China contestant Amanda's website called The Amanda Kimmel. The joke started from a Survivor Sucks forum post. Troyzan only played once. Despite being on seasons 24 and 34 of Survivor, many fans say Troyzan has only played one season. This is because of the invisible edit he received on his second season, Game Changers. Sue's Big Move. In an advertising promo for Australian Survivor 2016, a clip included said Sue's Big Move, implying something grand to happen in the following episodes, only to amount to nothing.
Sue fights back.
Not in a fit would I take orders from Flick, Brooke, or Elle.
What?
I have to pick my mark.
Does Sue do?
Surprisingly, we're now over halfway through the first half, arriving at Tier 4 International Survivor. The Poop Idol. After finding a secret idol at a challenge in Australian Survivor Season 5, Sharn placed the idol in the back of her shorts, only for it to fall out as she was walking back up to the group. Matt and Dave know each other. In Season 2 of Survivor New Zealand in Thailand, castaways Dave and Matt had a friendship outside the game, but didn't know either would be on until they showed up on set. Many saw this as a largely unfair advantage.
I do know one other contestant, which is bloody amazing. He's actually one of my best mates in high school.
Yeah, me and Dave were really good friends in high school. We played rugby together.
together. I used to, you know, stay at his house.
The Golden God. Australian Survivor Season 4 player David Jeannette referred to himself as the Golden God.
I'm crushing the game right now. I almost feel untouchable. I'm a Golden God right now. A Golden God. I'm a Golden God.
He returned the following season for All-Stars, where he took the win.
Winner of Australian Survivor All-Stars, David.
Idol passing. After Kez was voted out of Australian Survivor Season 8 Brains v Brawn, she passed her recently found but unused idol to Flick before leaving. The SA theme song is a banger. The theme song of Survivor South Africa is fire. The Outpost. A twist of Survivor New Zealand Season 2 in Thailand, where two tribes would each send someone to represent them in a 1v1 challenge that would result in a reward. The Palesa Idol. The sixth season of Survivor South Africa in the Philippines featured castaway Palesa finding and obtaining a hidden immunity idol from the podium at Tribal Council, similar to how Adam tried doing that in Season 40 Winners at War. Mateship. A prevailing struggle that contestants on various seasons of Australian Survivor have in terms of sending out one of their mates. JPL. Jonathan LaPaglia, the host of the modern incarnation of Australian Survivor, spanning from 2016 to present day. Champions vs. Contenders. The theme of the 5th and 6th seasons of Australian Survivor, which divides tribes into champions and those with celebrity status and contenders who are non-celebrities. Nico. Nico Panaggio, the host of Survivor South Africa since Season 3 in 2010 up to present day. OG Idol Nullifier. Season 4 of Australian Survivor included a twist known as the Super Idol, which was different than the US Super Idol in that it came in two parts of one regular idol and an idol nullifier.
This Super Idol splits in two halves. The first half is a Super Idol and it cancels the power of one immunity idol played at that tribal council. The second half is a normal hidden immunity idol.
Rock draw at Final 17. In the second episode of Survivor South Africa Philippines, a tie between Josie and Annalise occurred at Tribal Council, prompting a revote that was deadlocked. This led to a rock draw at Final 17, which sent Neil out. The French Sandra. The French version of Survivor known as Cole Lanta has its own two-time winning female player in Clemence Castel, who won the series' 5th and 22nd seasons. I'm sorry, Annalise. In the second season of Australian Survivor, Ziggy apologizes to Annalise as she casts her vote so loud that everyone back at Tribal can hear.
I'm sorry, Annalise. I'm voting you. So that we can keep our 5 strong.
Matt Chisholm. The presenter of Survivor New Zealand. He has been around since the first season premiere in 2017. Gina's Stolen Idol. In the 5th season of Survivor South Africa Champions, a tribe swap left Gina vulnerable. She was given an idol from her former tribe mates who whispered their plan to save her too close to her new tribe mates.
Had you just like whispered it out loud, like you could have just screamed.
They would get her away from her bag later on before Tribal, and when she got back to it, what was once the idol was now a piece of coral. 3-2-2-2. In the 19th episode of Australian Survivor Season 2017, there was a 3-2-2-2 vote for Tessa to ultimately leave. The other votes had included Sarah, Rocky, and Tara. The Salvation Cup. A twist in Survivor South Africa Season 5 Champions was that tribes would be coached by South African sports stars. While they couldn't vote or be voted out, they competed at challenges and lived at camp until jury, where they lived on Salvation Island. They would compete for the Salvation Cup, which gave them the power to burn a vote against the player of their choice at the next tribal. ASU 2017 is a top-tier season. Generally viewed as the best Australian Survivor season, as well as a fantastic season of the show all around. Christy has an all-time FTC performance. Christy Bennett, the winner of Australian Survivor Season 2016, is commonly praised for having an all-time final Tribal Council performance thanks to her confidence and articulation. She won in an 8-1 vote against Lee Carseldine, the Champagne Alliance. The Champagne Alliance was a group of 6 castaways from Australian Survivor Season 2017, comprised of Peter, Tessa, Michelle, Luke, Sarah, and Jericho. They are most commonly known for sending Henry out with an idol in his pocket in 10th place, Chizzy Points, a point system used by a handful of Survivor commentators on covering International Survivor every week. By the end, it is essentially a season-long scoreboard of strategic awareness per player. Finally, we have gotten up to Tier 5, References / Other Appearances. Rupert on Survivor Israel. In the third season of Survivor Israel, The Philippines, we see season 7 alumni Rupert show up as a reward in the reward challenge in episode 5, Colleen Haskell in The Animal. Season 1 Borneo alum Colleen Haskell co-starred with Rob Schneider in the 2001 comedy The Animal, BB on Family Guy. Peter recalls being on Survivor and talks to somebody who looks like BB and he calls BB, referencing the second vote out from season 1 Borneo.
How dare you wash your clothes in our drinking water, BB?
Total Drama Island, an animated parody of Survivor. There are other Total Drama seasons that parody other reality shows, totaling 117 episodes as of recording this. Around the World in 80 Ways, a reality show that aired on the History Channel in 2011 that features Boston Rob and race car driver Dennis Anderson traveling around the world through 80 different methods of transportation. Rob and Amber Against All Odds, a reality show chronicling Rob's pursuit of becoming a professional poker player by using their Survivor and Amazing Race winnings. The show only lasted one season with 10 episodes. Rob on Secret Celebrity Renovation. Arguably the newest piece of information on this list, Rob Mariano was the celebrity who was focused on in the 10th episode of Secret Celebrity Renovation on CBS on September 24th, 2021. Malcolm on The Bold and the Beautiful. Alumni Malcolm Freeberg from Philippines, Karamoan, and Game Changers made a cameo on an episode of The Bold and the Beautiful on February 13th, 2013. Joanna mentioned in The Office. In the Seance episode of The Office's fifth season titled Business Ethics, Ryan stands up and references Joanna from Survivor the Amazon, saying he dated a girl that looked exactly like her.
Anyone see Survivor season 6? Anyone know Joanna on that show? In New York City, I hooked up with a girl who looked exactly like that. Indistinguishable. So.
Okay. Well done.
Colby hosts Top Shot. Season 2 Australian Outback runner-up Colby Donaldson hosted a reality TV shooting competition called Top Shot on the History Channel from 2010 to 2013. Holding Hands, a reality show based on season 19 and 20 runner-up Russell Hance and his family. Though the pilot was never picked up by any network, the 7-minute trailer for it is available online. Flipped Off, a reality show on the A&E network, once again revolving around Russell Hance alongside his brother Sean and real estate agent Kristen Bredhoft as they flip properties around Houston trying to make a profit. The show had 7 episodes in its one season run. The Challenge Competitors. Players from both the US and international Survivor shows have appeared on another reality show called The Challenge, beginning with Turbo from Survivor Turkey on season 33 War of the Worlds, followed by Jay Starrett from Millennials vs. Gen X on season 35 Total Madness and season 36 Double Agents. Natalie Anderson had also appeared in the Double Agent season, but had to unexpectedly leave the game early on. In the season currently airing, they have Berna from Survivor Turkey, Emmanuel and Emmy from Survivor Romania, and Logan from Survivor Spain. They also had 3 players from the US show in Michaela Bradshaw from season 33 Millennials vs. Gen X, Season 32 Cow Wrong winner Michelle Fitzgerald, and Season 39 Island of the Idols winner Tommy Sheehan, but they were all gone within the first 4 episodes. Sugar in L.A. Noir. Season 17 Gabon alumni Sugar Kuiper voiced a character in Candy Edwards in the 2011 video game L.A. Noir. Coincidentally enough, the character also looks somewhat like her. Probst in How I Met Your Mother and 2 and a Half Men. In Season 7, Episode 4 of How I Met Your Mother, called the Stinson Missile Crisis, Barney promotes his own breast reduction consultation that has an endorsement by Jeff Probst on Survivor.
The challenge is brought to you by Dr. Barney Stinson's free breast reduction consultations.
At the end of the 7th episode of Season 11 of 2 and a Half Men, called Some Kind of Lesbian Zombie, one of the women Walden was seeing is now with a naked Jeff Probst who cooked her bacon. Sue, Jervis, Alicia, and Varner in the BB2 house. Survivor veterans Sue, Jervis, Alicia, and Jeff from seasons 1 and 2 had visited the Big Brother house during Big Brother 2 in 2001 for a night. Amanda and Parvati in Into the Blue 2. Survivor alum Amanda from China, Micronesia, and Heroes vs. Villains, and Parvati, winner of Micronesia, cameoed in the film Into the Blue 2 The Reef as themselves in a scene playing volleyball against 2 other girls. 180. Alumni of Token Sheen's Heroes vs. Villains and South Pacific Coach was the lead in a 2011 film entitled 180. Fellow Survivor alum Danielle DiLorenzo had co-starred in the film.
Oh, rock and roll, baby!
Wyatt Nash. Known as Matt Elrod originally from season 22 Redemption Island, he would go on to become an actor and change his name to Wyatt Nash. He can be seen in the show Dear White People as a reoccurring character, as well as an episode of Brooklyn Nine-Nine and the 2019 film Ford vs. Ferrari. Gandia on Judge Judy. Season 5 Thailand alum Gandia Johnson was in Season 22, Episode 8 of Judge Judy in November of 2017. MILF Island. A parody of Survivor in the sitcom 30 Rock was called MILF Island. Everyone is oddly obsessed with the show.
This show is the worst.
Suri and Aris on 30 Rock. A character on the sitcom 30 Rock is named Suri, and her fiancé's name is Aris. Though they weren't engaged, Suri and Aris were from the same season of Survivor of 12 in Panama. As Tina Fey has said she's a big Survivor fan, most fans assume she purposefully wrote this in. Survivor Celebrity Deathmatch. Celebrity Deathmatch was an old stop-motion claymation show that originally ran from 1998 to 2002. It parodied sports entertainment TV by depicting various celebrities engaging in stylized pro wrestling matches. In the show's Season 4, Episode 17 episode Fandemonium 4, the casts of Season 1 Borneo and Season 2 Australia were pitted against each other, with Jeff Probst as a guest ref. Ramona wins The Weakest Link. A Survivor edition of the Weakest Link TV series in 2001 featured Richard Hatch, Sue Hawk, Sean Kenneth, Joel Klug, and Ramona Gray, all from Borneo. Ramona ended up being the winner, taking home $32,000. Survivor Family Feud. A 2005 Castaways episode of Family Feud saw former female versus male competitors against each other. The women included Sue from Borneo, Shean from Thailand, Jenna from the Amazon, and Krista and Tijuana from Pearl Islands. The men were Richard and Rudy from Borneo, Ethan from Africa, and Fairplay and Rupert from Pearl Islands. Russell on Australian Survivor. Russell was a contestant of Australian Survivor Champions v Contenders in 2018. He was the second person voted out, back from the Outback. We get to catch up with the 16 former castaways after their time on the island, different from the reunion as it includes more personal follow-up interviews around the person's hometown. You can find it on Dailymotion. Jenna and Lindsay in Eminem video. In Eminem's music video for the song Without Me, Season 1 Borneo's Jenna Lewis and Season 3 Africa's Lindsay make cameos as essentially themselves for a brief moment. Jerry reference in Scary Movie 2. In the exorcism scene in Scary Movie 2, the priest makes a reference to Jerry Manthe being voted off Survivor, calling her some names in the process.
Who sent your only son into the world to crush that roaring tiger? And who got that unholy bitch Jerry kicked off of Survivor?
Amazing Racers. There have been 12 former Survivor players that went on to play The Amazing Race together. Rob and Amber were on Season 7 and 11, Ethan and Jenna were on Season 19, and Keith and Whitney were on 25. There were three pairs of former players on the show's 31st season in 2019, including Corinne and Eliza, Rupert and Laura, and Brett and Chris. Colby on Curb. In the fourth episode of Season 4 of Curb Your Enthusiasm called The Survivor, Season 2 Colby Donaldson gets mistaken for a Holocaust survivor.
Let me tell you, I was in a concentration camp. You never even suffered 1 minute in your life compared to what I went through.
Look, I'm saying we spent 42 days trying to survive. We had very little rations, no snacks.
Rock and Roll Jeopardy. A music-focused adaptation of Jeopardy called Rock and Roll Jeopardy aired from 1998 to 2001 with Jeff Probst as the host. So that's all the information I have for you today. If you learned anything, I'm glad to have taught you, and you can show your appreciation by either dropping a like or commenting whatever new fact you learned. Feel free to criticize me for leaving out whatever I inevitably did in the comments below as well. And if you didn't like the video, I'd love to know by you dropping a dislike. With all that being said, until I see you for tiers 6 through 10 in the next video, I'm Random Reality, and always remember, enjoy yourself.